And we caught up with Janet, as I said, an exclusive interview with us for Hey Hey, and I asked her if she was excited about being working with Michael basically for the first time ever in her life as a performer. And this is what Janet had to say backstage at Universal Studios in the caravan.
I'm very excited. It's the first time that my brother and I have actually sang together, aside from on his Thriller album, mm-hmm. PYT.
Yeah.
Those, na, 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 that was me. But that was just a little background thing he asked me to do. But we've never done a duet, and basically that's what this is.
Michael has always been a big fan of Janet's records, particularly Rhythm Nation. We had actually talked to him a while back after Rhythm Nation came out, like back in 89, and he had mentioned how much he liked the record, particularly the song of Knowledge. And we even went back and found like some of the sounds and stuff that we used on Rhythm Nation that we had kind of packed away, because Michael said he really wanted to have some of that element on, particularly on the duet, where you're going to try to merge what Michael does, but also what Janet does.
Well, actually, we had a hand in it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, along with Mark. It was, Mark had an idea about, you know, kind of spacey type thing, and just throwing in ideas here and there and taking it a little step further or backing up in certain areas. So it wasn't shocking, and seeing the drawings and working with the art director Tom Foden, which I've worked with before in the past. This is my first time working with Mark Romano.
Michael's fantastic.
He's wonderful. He's visually amazing. He's an incredible director, and he's very young, incredibly talented. And I think he's the perfect person for it, because when you think about his visuals and then putting that with the performance or the dance piece, which Mark hasn't really ever done. I think the closest that he got to it was the En Vogue video, but there really wasn't quite that much dancing in it. So to put the two together, I think it, you know, would just be something a little different.
Are you nervous even though it's Michael's project?
A little, actually. Yeah. I mean, you want to do something different with each thing that you do, and even though every time I do think about it, it's still our project, even though it's going on his album.
Yeah.
And we wrote the song together along with Jimmy. And it's still a part of mine as well, even though it's going on, like I said, going on his album.
Right.
And it's on with Sony and the whole bit. So you try to do something a little different each time. And it's very challenging.
We couldn't help but to look up to
him. Still do.
And still do, you know, in a lot of ways. We never imagined that we'd even meet him. And to have him even ask us to be on, you know, his album, you know, it's a true honor.
I'm not really nervous. I think the album speaks for itself. And the great thing about the record is that it's very much his feelings. I mean, You will never really have to ask Michael Jackson any questions about his feelings of the last couple of years, and really of his whole life. It's all there on the album. I think that this album is very, very important because it's like a crossroads. And he's defining it as a crossroads of his career by making it a greatest hits album. It's like he's acknowledging that this part of my career was great up till now, but I'm gonna move forward.
Well, keep having the fun. Best of luck with this.
And, thank you.
And it is great to see you.
You too. Nice
Michael
to see you.
And yourself
thank
together.
You.
And you. Oh, I love you.
I love you too.
All right, so there it is.
She looks so different.
She does. I'll tell you what, Daryl. She is absolutely stunning in real life. She truly is one of the stunning lady, Janet Jackson.